Hello dear children, today we will revise the fifth chapter, that is mass media and history. Now in mass media we have learned like what is mass media. So mass means the aggregation of the people or the people at large, and media means modes of communication. So the means of communication or the modes of communication in the earlier times which were used were according to the orders of the kings. A carrier would run in the streets beating drums and convey the news. Usually they used to go to the gathered place like the markets or the squares or the squares where four streets meet and where it is more population, and they used to beat the drums and call out in a very loud voice so that everybody would be able to, or rather the more number of people would be able to listen to it, and later on the people can communicate it to the others who haven't heard it. So this was one of the most commonly used, or this was the most important way of communication used it at the time when we had the monarchy. Now then the news would spread among the people by the word of mouth, like people used to tell each other, and that is how the news used to spread. Later on, as we moved on to the as we were under the British rule and we moved ahead, the modes of communication also changed. Later on, under the British rule, during the British period, people started receiving printed news through newspapers after the arrival of the British. Newspaper became a medium of circulating news, information and knowledge. So the newspaper came up, and the print media, we can say, started when we were under the British rule, and that started gaining popularity, and thereafter the more popular medium of communication became the newspaper, or the print media came into existence. So newspapers are it is a publication which mainly prints news, editorials, people's opinions and other contents. It is distributed regularly at a definite time. Now it is distributed regularly at a definite time, which means like few newspapers we get every day early in the morning, few papers are published in the morning, and they come they are available to the public by afternoon or evening. Some magazines or some newspapers are printed only once in 8 days, or once in 15 days, once in a month, or so it is said that it is distributed regularly at a definite time. Newspapers provide various local, national and international news. Newspapers are called the fourth column. The fourth column, that is the pillar of democracy. Why is it called so? Because it gives us the very important basic fundamental right, that is the freedom of expression, and this is the way through which a large number of people are communicated. It is possible to communicate to a large number of people through a single medium. So it is very important the correct information is passed on to a lot number of people, and therefore it is also called as the fourth pillar of the democracy. They are historical documents which record current events. Now in the earlier chapters we have also studied that history, or rather newspapers, serve as the written source of history. So these newspapers or the periodicals or journals what we get today serve the purpose of a historical document in the later part. In recent times, many newspapers have introduced e-newspapers. Now we are able to see that rather than the print media, there are e-newspapers. Like we get the newspapers on our mobiles or laptops or phones or whatever, like we get it in the digital media as well. In this chapter, we also discussed about news, which is a community needs news for the same reason that a man needs eyes. Like, we need to be vigilant, we need to see what is happening around us, we need to know what is happening around us. So it has to see where it is going, says the British author Dame Rebecca West. News is information from all over the land. The medium which prints this information is newspaper. England Gazette was the first newspaper started in England in 1966. James Augustus Hickey started the Bengal Gazette and laid the foundation of newspapers in India. In the later part, many newspapers were printed in English and other regional languages. So that is how we can see that the newspapers became very popular, because they were later on printed in the regional languages, which could be understood by everyone, as they were printed in the local regional languages. An important part of the periodicals is contributed by the magazines and journals. Now, what are magazines and what are their types? So, magazines which are published at regular intervals are called as periodicals. So, like if the magazines are sometimes the magazines are published generally once in a month. Sometimes it is a special edition, like once in a year also. So we have those Diwali special editions and all that stuff. So it is published once in a month. So these magazines which are published at regular intervals, like maybe once in a year or maybe once in a month or maybe once in 15 days. So these are called as periodicals. Now, magazines and journals are two types of periodicals. So periodicals itself are divided into two types, that is the magazines and the journals. They are categorized as weekly, bi-weekly, monthly, bi-monthly, quarterly, six-monthly, annual, etc., depending on the duration at which they are published. There may be some chronicles which are published at no fixed times. So generally they have a fixed duration wherein they are published bi-weekly or they are published monthly. But there can also be magazines and periodicals, or rather magazines and journals, which can be published at no fixed time, but that is very rare, or it generally doesn't happen that there is no fixed interval or there is no fixed time of their publication. Now, the early magazines. Magazines were like Balshastri Zambekar started the first monthly magazine in Marathi known as the Digdarshan. Pragati, now a defunct journal, was started in 1929 and edited by Triambak Shankar Shezwalkar. And the Marathi journals like Bhartiya Itihas Ani Sanskriti and Marathwada Itihas Parishad Patrika are the periodicals devoted to the Indian history in the present times. Present times means the history of that particular time. Present tense in that of that time, which is the past of now. A magazine is a periodical with a popular focus aimed at general public and containing news, personal narratives and opinions. Now, this magazine is generally meant, of course, for the public, and it is a periodical, like has a fixed period of publication, fixed period of time. And what does it aim at? It aims at popular focus, aimed at general public. It aims to providing information about to the general public, and it contains news, personal narratives, like people's, great people's, learned people's or scholars, their personal opinions is also published in that, and therefore it contributes a major part. Articles are written by professional writers. Magazines often have lots of eye-catching illustrations. Eye-catching illustrations is very catchy. You get attracted towards it quite easily. So, Times, Newsweek, Frontline, Outlook, Femina, The Week, etc. are some popular periodicals. As we discussed in brief about the e-newspaper, so in recent times, e-newspaper has got a prominent place in mass media. So in e-newspaper, news generally comes in sequence and not in accordance with importance like in a printed newspaper. So children, whatever are the important news, those are generally printed on the first page of the newspaper. Printed newspaper, but when we compare it with the e-newspaper, that is the electronic or the most ultra-modern way of publishing newspaper, digital journalism, that time the sequence is not in accordance with the importance. So the important news are published first. It is not like that. It is randomly published. We have to click on the news that we want to read, and then it appears on the screen in digital. There is a place provided to express opinion of the reader. Also here the readers get the opportunity or privilege to add their comments or react on the news. There is a place provided to express opinion of the reader. The Hindu, the Kesari became the first English and Marathi e-newspapers respectively. So the Hindu was the first English e-newspaper, and Kesari was the first Marathi e-newspaper. And presently almost all newspapers have their digital edition, that is the e-newspapers. After newspaper, the most popular form of spreading news or broadcasting was the Akashvani or the radio, or the AIR, that is the All India Radio. A private radio company, Indian Broadcasting Company, IBC, broadcasted daily programs, which was later taken over by the British government. So earlier it was started and then it was taken over by the it was started by a private company, Indian Broadcasting Company, and then later on when we came under the British rule, the British took over from the controls from them, from the British, the Indian Broadcasting Company. It was later named as Indian State Broadcasting Services, that is ISBS. And on 8th June 1936, it was named as All India Radio, AIR. AIR came under Information and Broadcasting Ministry of the Indian government after independence. So after independence, it was included in the Information and Broadcasting Ministry, government of India. A famous poet, Pandit Narendra Sharma, suggested the name Akashvani. So it is also popularly known as Akashvani also. After radio, the not only the news or the mass media, but it was overall taken over by the television, that is the Doordarshan. The first president of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, inaugurated Delhi Doordarshan Center. Mumbai Doordarshan was started on 2nd October 1972. Color television started on 15th August 1982, and a private channel started their telecast in 1991. So till 1991, although we had these television sets, but still we were able to see only for a limited time, because it was the programs were telecasted only by the government or the Doordarshan, and therefore it was for a limited time. Later on it was privatized, or there were private channels the way we see now, Zee and so Aaj Tak, Z, and then so many other channels, Star channels, and so many other channels which were added later on. So basically, Doordarshan is transmitting signals over long distance, was one of the greatest the most famous was the Scottish inventor John Lee Baird, and England, France and America all had operational television stations by 1939. Broadcasting for Indian televisions started on 15 September 1959, and from Delhi Doordarshan Center. Famous literary figures were P.L. Deshpande, and was the first producer of the Doordarshan. Now let us move ahead, and the most important question which is asked in the board exams quite popularly and quite frequently asked in the board exams is, why do we need mass media? So we basically need mass media to facilitate free flow of information to all the strata of the society. Now, all the strata means it should be communicated not only to the rich or the middle class, but it should also reach the lower class of the society, which contributes a major portion or the major population. To avail a platform to readers to express their views and opinions. So it should also give a platform or a space for the readers to express their views and opinions to make democracy stronger. So it helps in making the democracy stronger, because as we get the readers get the privilege to express their views and their opinions. So if they find something which is not correct in democracy, they can raise their voice, they can just speak up, and that is how democracy is, can say the best aspect of democracy is utilized. As television shows, visuals and images, it overcomes the limitations of newspapers. We can see videos which we cannot see in the newspapers. So that is how it was more popular than the newspapers, and it was able to reach to the more number of people, the more readers or the more viewers, we can say more precisely. To create social awareness and educate the masses. It is also used to create awareness and educate the masses. Now, whatever new developments are there, those can be reached to the public in an audio-visual format through the televisions, or now the e-newspapers, or rather we can say the social medias. Children, now this year, the portion which is covered in history this year, which is more of application of history, it is applied history. So now in the concluding part of this revision, we are going to see how the applied history or the application of history comes into picture. As far as newspapers is concerned, it is the application is to unfold the background of an event in the news. Then while reporting the news in detail, it is compared with a similar event in the past. For better understanding, newspapers resort to history. Now for example, if it is relating to some record made by someone in any particular sport, it becomes easy, or it becomes possible rather, because if we have the reference of the past record which was reduced to or extended, so we have the benchmark, we have the parameter, or we have the reference when we have the news of the earlier thing. So that is the application of the newspapers, like if we have the news which is saved or stored, it can be compared, it can be used as a parameter. The print columns about historical information under headings such as 50 years ago or 100 years ago. So when we discuss about things which, like when we saved, when the Doordarshan was started, and when 50 years were completed to the Doordarshan, or 10 years were completed to the Doordarshan, or anything, when 10 years or some 50 years, 25 years or 100 years are completed to a particular event, that can be compared, and there can be an analysis, and then we can have a flow, like how were the stages of development during these past 10 years or 50 years or 100 years. So in order to review the economical, social and political events, knowledge of similar events in the past is very essential. While writing columns to commemorate 100th year of an event having historical significance. So whenever we have these historical events like 10th year, 100th year, 50th year, it gives a very good analysis for us, and that is how the newspapers, which are at present only a source of information, become of the present or the current, become the source of information for the past events or the history as well. Now we will see how the history or application of history as far as Akashvani is concerned. While presenting programs celebrating Independence Day or Republic Day, references of speech made by previous prime ministers and presidents are given. Now, the first ever speech given by the first prime minister or the first president of the Democratic India on the auspicious occasion, or on the occasion of Republic Day or Independence Day or any other day, so it becomes a history, or it becomes a speech of a great importance. So those references or those recordings can be played, and that is how it helps in application part of the history. Knowledge of history is essential while planning radio programs. On the occasions such as birth or death anniversaries of national leaders, special programs are presented giving information about their work. For presenting programs like on this day in history, one needs to have knowledge of history. Like there were so many major incidences, like some invention, then there were some events in the history like the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, or the day when some great freedom fighter was hanged to death, or there are so many other events which do have a special importance. So these those days in the present can be also given reference of that, like on this day, what is this day important for that also we need the past records. Knowledge of history is helpful while presenting programs on historical events, leaders, or conducting discussions on the same. Also, we can see nowadays there are so many experts who discuss or debate, or there is can say so many people come as speakers on the forum, and they give us more information about someone or some incidents. So for that, the past knowledge or the knowledge of history is very, very important. At the end, we are going to see the application of history as far as television is concerned. While producing historical or mythological serials, maintaining accuracy with regard to the presentation of environment, outfit, weaponry, lifestyle, lingual expressions, etc. is essential. Like we have seen that in the past few years, there has been so much of changes in the, can say, the outfits, the clothes we wear, and what a few years back the people used to wear. So whenever there is a serial or a program which relates to mythology, or it relates to something in the past, so what type of environment was there, what type of outfits were there, what type of houses were there, then the weapons they used to use, how those were there. All this knowledge is very important, because while making those serials or documentaries or short films or whatever, these things play a very important role to create that effect and have that feel to the audience. We should have a deep understanding of history of the concerned period in order to present programs on lives of players, soldiers, heroics of men and women, achievers, umpires, forts, empires, forts, heritage, etc. Having knowledge of history is a must. It is very, very necessary. So that is how we can see that the newspapers or the Akashvani or the television has a very important role to play in the applied history as well. Now children, before we stop, I would like to tell you that this chapter, being very informative, and there is a variety of information which is given in this chapter, so it is very important as far as examination, board exam is concerned. So it is very important that you go through this chapter again and again and revise it. There are so many important questions in this chapter which can be you asked as short notes or comparisons. Then in the form of brief answers also. It's like comparisons like mass media and professional opportunities. Then you can also be asked as electronic or digital journalism or web journalism. You will have to, you can be asked about the information. Then how television is the most popular medium, you have to write a short note or you have to explain the statement. Then newspapers is an important medium of education and information. So knowledge of history is essential for newspaper articles. So these are some of the very important questions which are very frequently asked, especially mass media and objectives of newspapers. Then need of mass media or mass media and professional opportunities. So these are the very frequently asked questions which you should definitely go through and be perfect with. Thank you children, thank you so much.